In the Brummage line, you have the real constant a. But how can you find out what this a should be? Well, you know that a has to be chosen such that the integral of f of t times e to the power minus a times t converges. But you do not know f of t, because that's the function you're trying to determine. However, still this criterion will tell us how to choose a, as you will learn in this video. Okay, you don't know your f of t, but you know that it's of exponential order, so it's bounded by m times e to the power a1 times t, where a1 is some constant, t is positive. And we have learned that in that case, this integral capital F of S is uniformly convergent if the real part of S is bigger than a1, and even stronger, capital F is analytic if the real part of S is bigger than a1. Okay, still don't know a1 because you do not know your small f. Well, now, if you put your a2, the a2 from the Brummage line, if you put it now bigger than a1, so you make your a2, the one which you are going to put in your Brummage line, bigger than the a1, then your integral, your second condition is satisfied. Your integral e to the power minus a2 times t times f of t, if you integrate that, is smaller than infinity. And why is that? Well, your the norm of your a to the power minus a2 times t times f of t is smaller than m times, capital M times, e to the power a1 minus a2 times t. So if you make sure that a2 is strong enough, larger than your a1, then you will get e to the power minus t. Your exponent is a negative number in front of the t. And if you integrate that one, you will go down to zero fast enough. Integrate that one, the integral will exist. So if you pick your a2 bigger than your a1, you're fine, because then you know you satisfy all criteria. Ah, but we still don't know the a1, so what can we do? Well, we know from our a1 that if you have some singularities over here, the yellow dots, that they are all to the left of the line where the real part of S equals a1, because our function is analytic to the right of that line, where the real part of S bigger than a1. Furthermore, we know that the a2 is can be chosen. If we choose it bigger than a1, then we are happy, and we are done. So if we choose our a2 such that all singularities are to the left of our line, then we will certainly need to do that. Also, all yellow dots definitely have to be to the left of our line where the real part of S equals a2. But then, if we choose our two, we have to choose our a2 maybe big, it may be some big constant because you don't know where a1 is. However, what can you do then? So here we have our a2, which has to be bigger than our unknown a1. But now let's pick any a over here, such that the line real part of S equals a, such that all singularities are to the left. So it may very well be that our a could have been to the left of our a1, don't know. But then we can do the following trick. We can form the contour along L1, real part of S equals a2, L2, and the other one over here. We can form the close contour. Actually, no yellow dots are inside. So the integral along the contour consisting of L1, L2, LA2 and LA, that integral equals zero because we can apply Cauchy-Gaussat. So now we only have to get rid of the contributions along L1 and L2, and if we are able to do that, then we can shift our integral along A2 to A. And if we are able to shift it to A, then we know that any line to the right of all our singularities will do in order to compute our Brummage integral. Well, when can we get rid of the integrations along L1 and L2? Well, if your capital F is bounded by some MR, then going to zero, then we can do this. Total integral is always equal to zero. Take limits of R to infinity. L1 joint L2 dsds, the ones over there, minus the one LA going down, plus the one LA2 going up. And then you know, because this integral over here vanishes by an ML estimate. That's the integral along LA equals the integral along LA2. So that means that any line, wherever you put your A, can be will do the job as long as you stay to the right of all your singularities. So that is how you have to pick, how you can choose your A from your Bromwich integral.